Greetings sa Destiny City Church. Magpamalandong kita sa lain naman ng pamaagi kaanay sa ginhimo natin sa una tungod sa dugang restrictions dala sa pag-shoot up naman sa mga cases sa COVID. Pero may kaso tungod kay church kita ni Jesus Christ, kay balo kita mag-adjust. And so, aton nga isintro ang aton pangunahuna sa Ginoo, siningation. Ginahimo nato ini tungod kay gusto nato nga safe man kamo kag ako man ang tanang mga kultura naton kag wala man mapuhina ng aton nga entusiasmo para sa Lord. We want to discover more of the Word of God. We want to be encouraged. Gani nga siningation, I want you to open your Bibles sa aton nga pagsugilanunan karon nga aga. It is found in Hebrews chapter 10 verses 19 to 25. Ang aton nga ginatunaan, title naton sa series naton, Final Check. Sa diin gina-check up naton ang aton nga kahimtangan in preparation sa last days, preparation sa end times or sa second coming ni Jesus. Ini nga verses nagasiling diri verse 19. Therefore, brothers, since we have confidence to enter the holy places by the blood of Jesus, by the new and living way that he opened for us through the curtain, that is through his flesh. And since we have a great priest over the house of God, let us draw near with a true heart in full assurance of faith, with our hearts sprinkled clean from an evil conscience and our bodies washed with pure water. Let us hold fast the confession of our hope without wavering, for he who promised is faithful. And let us consider how to stir up one another to love and good works, not neglecting to meet together as is the habit of some, but encouraging one another, and all the more as you see the day drawing near. Ang last phrase, as you see the day drawing near. Ang encouragement diri sa aton nga mga tumulo, among nga preparahon nato ng aton nga kagalingon, kag-check up naton ang aton nga daily dose adlaw nga pagkinanglan sa ginatawag nga encouragement. Kay bisan anong bagay nagatahaw, ang gugma nagatahaw, ang kalayo nagatahaw, ang hindi dapat magtahaw among aton nga pagtuo sa Lord, ang aton nga love sa Ginoo, hindi na dapat magtahaw. Gani gina-encourage kita diri nga butangan gid nato ang aton nga kabuhi sang mga ihambal ko nga tatlo kadalag ko nga tikang nga buhaton naton para may elemento kita pirmi sa ang ginatawag nga encouragement. Encouragement will be like something that we carry along with us every day, every moment. Tungod kay ining last days, puno sa mga bagay nga nagapadiscourage sa aton. Siguro kung mismo makapamatuod sina, enumerate ko ang iban nga mga bagay nga naibaluan nato nagadiscourage sa aton in these last days. Ginambal man ini ni Jesus, gin-predict sa mga prophets, kag ginhambal man sa mga apostles niya sa scriptures. Discouraging conditions of the last days. Like sabi ni Jesus, in the last days, the love of many will grow cold. Wickedness will abound, and the love of many will grow cold. Nga ang kahulugan sina, nga there will be too much faithlessness sa isa kay isa, disloyalty, abandonment, break up sa mga relationship. Siling siyang balani ko sa natan, in these last days, many will depart from the faith. Tungkol sa madamong deception, madamong mga pagtilaw, kag-wickedness, many Christians will depart from the faith. Siling ganit rin sa Book of Hebrews, even people who love the Lord will start thinking about drawing away from the living God. Wow! Sa pagit, many will be deceived in these last days. kinanglan nato encouragement sa aton nga nahibaluan kag paghibalo sa pagtuo ang Word of God kay madamo nga mga false religion, false teachings, fake news. Dapat may ara kita nga ginahawiran kag ginatindugan mga factual mga bagay, ebidensya sa aton dapat nga pagatuohan. In these last days, ginasiling man nga there will be increase of wickedness. Very impure ang pagkabuhi sa mga tao. Immorality, adultery, fornication, and all kinds of evil will spread. Dasan sini nga last days man, there will be a reign of terror. Fear will be controlling the emotion and the behavior of people. Crimes and persecution against the church. Days of cruelty and anger and hatred. Amo na ang picture sa last days. Depression will be the result of that. There will be many sorrows. People will experience failures, shaming and blaming. And then also added to that, the demonic activity will increase. My witchcraft, my drugs and drug abuse, my satanism that will spread all over the world. And then added to that, sa finances, economic collapse, bankruptcy, reset ko no sa money system or financial system. And then added to that, natural disasters, epidemics or pandemics, earthquakes, flooding, tsunami, and many kinds of natural disasters that will take place in the world affecting all of us. And then of course there will be battles and killings and wars and rumors of wars. Kung ano ang picture sa last days, hindi bala dapat lang nga preparahan ta ang aton nga kumbaga ang aton resource sa aton ginatawag nga encouragement. Where will we get this encouragement? Kamuy gani ina ang ginahambal diri sa Hebrews chapter 3, the same book, chapter 3 verse 12 to 14. Siling ni Paul, siling niya, watch out brothers and sisters, so that there won't be any of you an evil, unbelieving heart that turns away from the living God. We describe niya ang danger that people will turn away from the living God. Verse 13, siling niya, but encourage each other daily. That is very, very important encouragement kag exhortation sa aton. Siling diri, encourage each other daily. May regular kitang encouragement dapat. Siling diri, while it is called today, so that none of you is hardened by sin's deception. For we have become participants in Christ if we hold firmly until the end the reality that we had at the start. You remember, pag-start mo, how on fire ikaw sa Lord, in love ka sa Ginoo, kag ikumparar ina sa subong, siguro yung makatestify ikaw that there is a draining, there is a decreasing of the warmth of your love for God or your faith in God. Kay tungod sa pag-atake sa mga discouragement nga nag-aabot sa aton. Kamo na ginahambalan kita diri. Encourage each other daily. Without encouragement bala, ari ang mga mangin posible nga mga resulta. Without encouragement, we will lose our ability to stay strong and faithful. Even until the end, there will be the evil of unbelief will set in. And then without encouragement, we are easily tempted to draw away from serving the living and true God. Without encouragement, in other words, we will fail to end well sa aton nga paglakat, aton journey, and aton faith sa Lord. So, here's the question. How then should we live? How then should we live? Can we get the source of encouragement daily as encouraged and as stated sining in scriptures? Of course, the answer is yes. Dili sa sining ginbasa naton sa Hebrews chapter 10, there are three great action steps that we need to make in order to have regular and strong encouragement on the daily basis. Three great action steps. These steps can be discerned or can be clearly understood as it is introduced by the expression let us. For example, number one nga step gibuhaton naton ginhambal diri sa Hebrews 10:19-22 nga nagasiling let us draw near. Let us draw near with a true heart and full assurance of faith, with our hearts sprinkled clean from an evil conscience and our bodies washed in pure water. Starting with verse 19, siling diri, brothers and sisters, since we have the boldness to enter the sanctuary through the blood of Jesus, he has inaugurated for us a new and living way through the curtain that is through his flesh, and since we have a great high priest over the house of God, amo na yung conclusion sa sining portion, let us draw near. In other words, the first step is, let us draw near to the presence of God. I believe that is the first step, and not only the first step, the greatest step that we can take, because this is the greatest source of all encouragement. Sa isang sulatan, the God of all comfort will comfort us. The God of hope and the God of encouragement. So ang unang step ng buhaton gitna ton is to draw near to the person and the presence of God. Very, very important. Let us draw near. Inang statement, ginasolve naton ang problem sa distance naton sa Lord. Kaya kung kaisa, umpisa kita mga lapit kita sa Lord, suod kita sa Lord, ginahambala kita sa ambalaan ng kasulatan nga, draw near to God and He will draw near to you. Kung dumduman nato inang step, kung itake nato inang step, then the temptation to draw away from the living God will be resolved. We bring ourselves closer to God. We bring ourselves closer to God. So mangkut ka, how close? How close you should you be to God? Of course, ikaw lang magdetermine sila. Sila yung pasang amigo ko sila. It's up to you. Ginasugo kita nga, draw near, draw closer to God. It is now your choice. Doon naman mo ang advertisement sa close-up nga toothpaste. May ara ka nga, close-up confidence. Amo na ang gusto natin makita sa ato relasyon kay Lord. Because in that way, encouragement from God will be available for all of us. The biggest secret, if you ask me, of all, the biggest secret of all, the encouragement that we need, where we can get it, is staying close to the presence of God. Ang encouragement sa atong diri ginambalan kita, that we are now able to enter the sanctuary. You know what is sanctuary? Sanctuary is a sacred, holy place, ginatawag sa Old Testament nga, the meeting place where you meet the presence of God, the sanctuary. We can now enter the sanctuary through the curtain or veil. Yan ang symbolism ini. Kung gabasa ka, tebalo ka sa the tabernacle and then the temple of God, may ara ang holy place, that's my holiest place. Ang nag-separate sa holy place, kag holiest place, amo nang ginatawag nga curtain. Kag ginambal diri sini nga verse, that we can now enter into that holiest place by the curtain that was opened or reintroduced ginpahayag ni Jesus, ginbuksan niya ang kurtina so that there is no access to the holiest presence of God. Dito sa temple, the temple veil, we can now enter into the presence of God, the immediate presence of God, in the house of God. You know, the house of God is His dwelling place. Do you like that? Do you like to experience the fact that in every day of your life, may ara ka nga encouragement tungod kay ara gid ikaw sa presensya ni Lord? You have an open door to enter into the presence of God. I really believe this if you read the entire Old Testament, that the history of man is always about how to come back to the presence of God. Sin has separated us from God. And the fall of man has closed that door into the presence of God. Wala na makabalik si Adan sa presensya sa Lord. It was a rare experience all throughout the Old Testament. unless God comes to them and speak to them, they would not have an experience of the presence of God, which brings so much power and encouragement. Sa New Testament, however, tungkol sa ginhimo ni Jesus, it is now possible to come back once and for all into the presence of God. Amo nang ginahambal sining a verse. And how? How can we experience, how can we return, how can we come back into the presence of God? Ang ginahambal diri for two important conditions. Because of two conditions, it is now possible to go back into the presence of God, enter into the presence of God, and draw near at all times. Ang una condition, siling diri sa verse 19 to 20, therefore, brothers, since, look at that, since we have boldness or confidence to enter into the holy place by the blood of Jesus, ang conclusion dito sa verse 21 is, let us draw near. Since we have confidence, since we have boldness to enter into the presence of God. You know, in ang boldness or confidence, that means there is a time in your walk in faith, maybe when you are starting with God, when you become fearless and daring. Wala kaya na dok magsulod sa presensya ni Lord. Kay tungod, una, napatawad ka niya. Ginbuksan ni Jesus ang lugar para na makasulod ka sa presensya niya. Siling diri, let us draw near with a true heart and full assurance of faith. That is very, very important in this condition. Jesus has given us full assurance of faith. Because of what Jesus did, may ara kita confidence. Wala kita yan nag-alang-alang o nag-apalagyo sa presensya ni Lord. I believe that if you take this first step, you need boldness. Again, you need boldness inside your heart to enter into His presence. Jesus made a way, siling diri, through the blood of Jesus that He has inaugurated for us, a new and living way through the curtain. Hallelujah. There is a living way for Christians to enter into the immediate presence of God. Amo na ang ginahambal diri sa sininga scriptures. Because of His blood sacrifice and because of His broken body. It was a perfect sacrifice, by the way. Siling sa Hebrews 10. Pasalan ko bala, alin sa verse 10, ang atras lang kita gamay. Siling diri, and by that will we have been sanctified through the offering of the body of Jesus Christ, once for all. And every priest in those days stands daily at his service, offering repeatedly the same sacrifices which can never take away sins. But when Christ had offered for all time a single sacrifice for sins, he sat down at the right hand of God, waiting from that time until his enemies should be made a footstool for his feet. For by the single offering, he has perfected for all time those who are being sanctified. In other words, what Jesus Christ did for you, he offered his life for you. You are now acceptable to God. And because you are now acceptable to God through the blood of Jesus, you can enjoy access. Makasulod ka sa presensya sang Diyos. Verse 17, siling diri, then he adds, I will remember their sins and their lawless deeds no more. Where there is forgiveness of this, there is no longer any offering for sin. Your sins will not be remembered anymore. Wala na rason nga madlok ka, magsulod sa iya presensya. You gain confidence. And then siling diri, where forgiveness of sins is there is no longer any offering for sin. Wala ka na require sa additional pang offering para sa iyong mga sala, kay kumplito na, sufficient ang ginhalad ni Jesus na iya nga kamatayon kag iya dugo dito sa Kalbaryo. So that's the first condition. A door has been opened, and because of that, may ara kita boldness and confidence. The second condition is stated in verse 21. Siling diri, and since we have a great high priest. Importante na nga word ng since. Since we have confidence to enter. Since we have a great high priest. In other words, siling diri, si Jesus, amo na atong high priest, siya ang mag-open pag-gate, mag-bulig sa aton to enter into the presence of God and to draw near. Jesus as High Priest is the one who draws near, helping us to draw near to God. He went ahead of us into the presence of God. He entered into the holiest place for us. He represents our cause. He will speak to God in our behalf. Si Jesus, bilang High Priest, masulod siya dito at istoryahon niya ang aton amay sa langit, parte sa aton. He carries our sacrificial offering when he entered there. He brought his own blood. And sinisang balaan sa atan, dili sa Book of Hebrews, beginning chapter 2, ang aton nga Ginoo amo ng faithful High Priest. Matutong nga High Priest, effective High Priest para sa aton. Ang gin-offer niya nga sacrifice bilang High Priest is perfect. Wala na ginasulit-sulit, parehos ang ginahambal sa iba nga may daily mass sacrifice sila kay Jesus siya once and for all lang, kay kumplito na. He is a great High Priest. So, that's the first step. Siling din to access and to have encouragement on a daily, regular basis, you need to take the step of drawing near to the presence of God. Ini nga step nag-build sang faith. Tandaan din ninyo na. If you are able to experience daily the presence of God, it builds faith. Ginahambal diri, you draw near with true and sincere faith. Sincere heart with full assurance of faith. You know, heart and faith cannot be separated. So isang Bible, with the heart, man believes. So, with true and sincere heart, with full assurance of faith, being sprinkled clean from all evil conscience, siling dirising, siling nga verse, and our bodies washed in pure water. In other words, everything that needed to be cleansed in order to enter into the presence of God, ginhimo sa dugo ni Kristo. Limpyo ang lawas, ginahugasan ni kaos, sa Bible, ang pulong niya naghimo sa imong balaan, ang imong conscience, ginlimpyohan niya, ang imong tagipuson, ginpaputli niya, ginlimpyo, sprinkled clean, sinindiri, from all evil conscience, and therefore, may kaisog kita. I wish we can pray like David, nga siling niya, I have only one request, siling ni David, one thing I require from the Lord, siling niya, and it is what I desire, and this is to dwell in the house of the Lord all the days of my life. Muna ginambal nato kaya enter into the sanctuary. Siling niya, I want to dwell in the house of the Lord all the days of my life, gazing on the beauty of the Lord and seeking Him in His temple. For He will conceal me in His shelter in the day of adversity. He will hide me under the cover of His tent. He will set me high on a rock. My heart says this about you, O Lord. Seek His face. Lord, I will seek your face. Kamay pa muna atong prayer. First step kini. Draw near into the presence of God. Hallelujah. Amen. You know what the invitation of Jesus? Doon naman niya? Matthew 11, 29 to 30. Siling ni Jesus, come unto me all you who labor and are heavy laden. So siling niya, I'll give you rest. Take my yoke upon you. That's the next thing you need to do. You're so attached to the Lord. Naguta ikaw upod sa kay Lord. Nagpasaan kita sang guta upod kay Lord. Take my yoke upon you. Kag siling niya, I will give you rest. You will find rest on your soul. Hindi ka kinanglan ma-discourage kung ara ang presensya sa Lord sa imo. So take that first step. Now, let us go to the second step. The second step is found in verse 23. Siling diri, let us hold on to the confession of our hope without wavering, since He who promised is faithful. So our second step, state naton, is to hold on to the promise. Hold on to the promise. And number one, let us draw near to the presence of God. And number two, let us hold on to the promise. I believe ining a step is the surest source of encouragement. The surest source of encouragement is the Word of God, the Word of promise that our God made in His words. We can trust in God, and trust in God involves not only the confidence in His ability, in His divine ability, but confidence in His faithfulness to perform what He said He will do. Kadamo sa mga Christians na na-discourage sila. Number one, tungod kay wala sila nakatago sa pulong sa Diyos sa ilahan. They don't remember anything because they did not memorize or understand the Word of God. The closer you hold on to the Word of God, which is filled with plenty of promises, silipan ni Peter, great, abundant, great and precious promises. Siling niya, ara ginatay sa aton sang Lord ang great and precious promises. Kung hindi ka sila kahibalo, kag wala mo na natunan, that will be a source of discouragement for you. Amunang ginahambal din nga, let us hold on to the promise. You must discover the promises of God, and there are plenty in the scriptures. We need to hold on to His word. And in holding on to His word, it will make your heart and your mind stable and strong and unquestioning. Nga makaka-entertain ka pa sa discouragement if you know the Word of God. Kung natago ba na sa imong heart. Siling diri, let us hold on to our confession of our hope. You know what that means? That means on a daily basis, you confess or you agree or you repeat. Do you repeat what you believe? You put words, you speak about your conviction concerning the promises of God. Kag ini nga confession naton sa aton nga hope, nag-encourage na sa aton. In fact, in the scriptures, hope and encouragement are almost the same. Kwa ba lang hope, wala ka encouragement. Pero kung may encouragement ka, may hope kagit. Hope meaning that you are feeling good about the future. You know that the future is okay. It's fine. Bisa ano pa ihambal sa mga tao, bisa ano pa makita mo, mga bad news, o kung ano pa kina-predict sa mga tao, mga kalalakan para sa aton, we can still trust in the promises of God. May aragin kita kaligunan, kag source ina sa aton nga encouragement. Especially in these last days. It means that all that we believe and what we say is always in agreement with the promises of God. How do you do that? How do we hold on to God's promises? Siling diri, without wavering. Hold on to the promises of God without wavering, without doubting. Nga dapat ang sa mind ni mo, you are fully decided nga mo ni ang hawiran mo nga pulong kag saad sa Dios. No changing of mind, no turning back on the Word of God. Ang word ko nung holding on to the confession of our hope, that word can be illustrated through like a drowning man. May isa katao nga galumos siya sa butad lang nato sa Pacific Ocean siya. Na gakalumos-lumos siya kag inichan mo siya sa lubid. And holding on means you are drowning and now your only source of safety and your life is hanging on to that rope. Uyatan mo gid the rope of safety. You cling for dear life into that. That's how we need to treat the Word of God. We hold on to the Word of God. You know, in the book of Hebrews chapter 6 verse 18 to 19, nagasiling dire, so that through two unchangeable things in which it is impossible for God to lie, we who have fled for refuge might have strong encouragement to seize the hope set before us. Listen to that. Siling diri nga may duha ka bagay nga unchangeable. Number one, ang promise ang Lord. Ang kung ano unod, ang content sa iyang promise. Ikaduha, ang ginhimo niya nga vow. Siling dira sa Hebrews chapter 6. So he made a promise and he assured it with a vow. Kag siling niya, muna yung duha kabagay sa din, it is now impossible for God to lie. kagkita nga nagpalapit sa iya for refuge, will have strong encouragement. What a big word. Because of the promise of the Lord and the fact that he cannot tell a lie, it is impossible for him to tell a lie, we have this strong encouragement. And we hold on to the hope that is set before us. Silindri, we have this hope as an anchor, angkla, sangkalag, the anchor for the soul, firm and secure. It enters the inner sanctuary behind the curtain. So, nami ning a step. This step will build hope. The first one, entering into the presence of God, will build your faith. But this one, holding on to the word and the promises of God, knowing that God will never tell a lie, then it will build your hope. Hold on to our conviction until the end. Fixing your eyes on Jesus, who is the author and the finisher of our faith. Wow. Fixing your heart on God's word. The world and everything in the world will pass away, but his word will never pass away. You start reading the Bible. You start understanding it and memorizing it. You start applying it in your life. And every day you will have that daily supply of encouragement from his word. Many of you can testify that reading the Bible builds strong confidence in God and builds your faith. Titus chapter 1, verse 2 to 3. Silingdiri, in the hope of eternal life that God, who cannot lie, promised before time began. Even having everlasting life is based on that strong promise of God. Nga ginahambal ni Titus nga, we have this hope of eternal life. Kag ang hope ini is really very strong, it's stable. Why? Because this was given by God who cannot lie. He gave it even long time ago before time began. Verse 3 of Titus 1. In his own time, he has revealed his word in preaching with which I was entrusted by the command of God our Savior. Many of you were saved because of that word of promise. Everlasting life, forgiveness, salvation, and many, many more. Hang on to the word of God. Hebrews chapter 3 again, verse 13 to 14. Silingdiri, encourage each other daily. While it is called today, so that none of you is hardened by sin's deception. We need to have an encouragement daily. Therefore, eat the word of God daily. Man shall not live by bread alone, but by every word that comes from the mouth of God. One time si Paul, istorya siya sa mga Christians sa Thessalonica. These Christians are experiencing persecution, and some of their friends and loved ones died. So Paul has to speak to them, saying na, hindi ka magkagdo, kay hindi man na sila mabilin, diri magabot si Jesus. In fact, magabot si Jesus, ina sila, mabanhaw una, gusto kita, sa niton upod sa ila, there will be a reunion with the Lord in the air. Ginambal yan na sa 1 Thessalonians 4. Verse 18, sila niya, therefore, encourage one another with these words. The fact that Jesus promised to come back, the fact that Jesus promised resurrection to all of us, in spite of threats, in spite of the danger, then we can have encouragement. Siling padre sa ni Paul sa Thessalonians, encourage one another, exhort one another, strengthen one another, build each other up with these words. So that's number two. So now, let's go to step number three. Makita ini sa verse 24, 25, yung basa natin kayo na. Let us consider one another in order to provoke love and good works, not neglecting to gather together as some are in the habit of doing, but encouraging each other, and all the more as you see the day approaching. In other words, tuduan kita to take the step of caring for God's people. Let us consider each other and care for God's people. Amo nang ginahambal sa verse 24, verse 25. I believe this is the most practical step of encouragement. Some of you may be slow in understanding how to enter into the presence of God. And some of you may be slow in reading or understanding or applying the scriptures. But for practical purposes and for you to be motivated to practice the Word of God and to receive that kind of encouragement, you need the church. You need the people of God. The most practical encouragement where we readily enjoy this one, it is the one provided by God. The church is God's church. And meeting together as brothers and sisters is God's provision for the people of God, where we are told to keep meeting together, regularly meeting together. So, how does this encouragement happen? Meeting or considering or having a gathering as a church. How does this happen? How is this done? According to this verse, first verb, action word there is the word consider. You consider each other. You consider your brothers and sisters. Consider one another. That word means you give attention to each other. That means to be thoughtful about each other. To weigh, timbangon mo kung ano mga bagay ang magabulig sa imong mga kulturan sa Ginoo. That means to be sensitive to each other's need. Amo lang una nga ma-apply mo ining step. How do you care for God's people? Be sensitive. Be considerate. Kung kaysa we gather in prayer meeting, Bible study, or even in a big gathering as a church, nga naga-attend kita, pero wala kita sinang sensitivity nga ma-sense naton o mabatsyagan naton ang mga kasubo nila, ang mga ginabatsyag lang ang mga problema. And so we don't benefit them and we are not also benefited. So ang first step galing ginapal din is to be considerate, to give attention to one another. Hindi lang kayo nang daw nagpasiplatay lang kamo o nagkumustahanay kamo or in your fellowship. Even sometimes in a family group, nakita ko gidna nga kung wala bala inang pagsunod sining humble diri, to be considerate, nga maging sensitive kita, the day pass one after another day, and then weeks and months, nalipatan naton nga maging mabinatyagon. Nagtigulang naman kabataan naton, they have not received any encouragement from us, or people having problem, we look at their eyes, but because we do not discern immediately, hindi kita sensitive, hindi natin sila ma-offeran some encouragement. We need to be sensitive first of all. That's how this verse is saying. Let us consider one another. Ang ikaduha, siling diri, and to provoke each other to love and good works. I like that word provoke. That word provoke means that you fire them up. You inspire them. A strong word is you incite these people towards loving and towards good work. Nga mangin fervent ang ila love sa Lord, kag mangin active ang ila pagpangabudlay tungod kay nagahigugma sila sa Lord. Provoking one another means you exhort each other and you counsel. Advice ka sa ila nga, let's love the Lord and let's love one another. Let's love other people. Let's even love our enemies, praise God. And then, to do good works. Because love without works, what is that? So, siling diri, provoke love and good works. That's why it is practical. The most practical step in finding encouragement is to be a caring person, to take care of God's people, and then to speak to them and incite and provoke them, encourage them. Ang ikatatlo diri sa verses yung ibasa naton is to gather, the gathering together. To gather together is a requirement for us to connect, to understand and connect, and to see what is wrong or what is right with each other. To gather, to meet face to face. Bisan subong nga wala kita daw hindi pa kita kagather tungod sa gina-prevent nato ng dugang infection, kagluyag nato ng healthy ang tanan ng mga tao. And what is 2 weeks or 3 weeks para lang ma-safeguard nato ng inyong safety? Okay? But the truth of the matter is, we need, as people of God, to gather together, to meet. Ining going to church service, siling natin na going to church. For many, many years, I believe, kaginambal man dili siling a verse, it is the most neglected or the most abused method nga gin-provide sang God sa atong tani, pero gina-neglect natin. In fact, in the Old Testament, they consider it a blessing to be together with the brothers. Kaya dira kuno sa blessing, dira kuno nga naga-tipon kita sa Psalms 133, when we gather together as brothers and sisters, God commands the blessing. Importante ang pagtililipon sa mga kaanakan sa Diyos sa Old Testament at sa New Testament. In fact, if you are reading the Old Testament account, ginahambal sa balat sulatan nga one form of punishment sa isa ka tawo nga nagatinunto sa relasyon niya sa Lord o kung nasupak niya ang kasuguan sa Lord. One form of punishment is to excommunicate that person, i-cut him off. Hindi na siya maka-fellowship. In other words, inang hindi ka ka-attend sa meeting na gintawag ni Lord nga sa dinara si Lord presente sa tunga. Kung hindi ka sila ka-attend, you are being punished. That's the concept of the Old Testament. In the New Testament, not only that we can draw close to God and read His Word, but we can minister to one another in a big fellowship. Sa New Testament, kung ang isa katawag yun sa wine, sa Matthew 18, wala siya naginursol. Dason, gindalaan siya sa mga witnesses, wala man siya naginursol. Sa command ni Jesus nga, consider him like a pagan, nga hindi siya membro sa inyong katilingban. Sa practice, sa tradition, gintawagin na nga excommunication. Can you imagine nga kung i-excommunicate ka, punishment ina, nga hindi ka nakaupod sa mga tumuluo, wala ka na sing ma-contribute sa ila, kag wala man sila sing chance nga mag-contribute sa imong spiritual life. It's a punishment. Kung maintindihan natin ina, hindi na natin sugod karon pag i-neglect o kung pag i-avoid ang ginatawag nga meeting together. We don't want to be cut off from the family of God. Sa time nga ginsulat ining Book of Hebrews, it has become a trend, an evil habit of separating from each other and staying away from the fellowship, refusing to meet with other believers. It became their practice. Kani ginsaway sila ni Paul. We need this, especially in these last days. We need to meet face to face. We need to be loyal to one another. Gina-encourage yung gina mga taga Destiny City Church. You have been taken care of here. We are being loved and nurtured. There is a regular taking care of your spiritual life. Be loyal to your church. Be happy, enthusiastic to meet together with believers. Hallelujah. Ang ikaapat din nga gina-mention is after that we are gathered together and we consider one another, we provoke one another, we encourage each other. Siling din sa siling a verse. Encouraging each other and all the more as you see the day approaching. That means building each other up. In a meeting bala nga magpauli ka din sa imong prayer meeting or fellowship meeting or Bible study, you become stronger than the time before you enter and before you join. And you feel so strong inside and ara-ara sa height sa imong faith, you want to fly, you feel like you're floating in the air because your faith has been encouraged. You have hope, hallelujah, and then na-encourage gini ka. And this happens because we do not abandon the brotherhood and the meeting of each other. So ganing exhortation sa atong diri that this meeting together and this loving one another, this ministry to each other, hallelujah, is very important, especially in this day as you see the day approaching. That means when you look at what is happening around, you sense it in your spirit, the day of His coming is near. The day of the appearing of Jesus is near. The day of the judgment of God is near. When you see these things, it is adding to the importance of meeting together. So that is the exhortation. Hallelujah. We build each other. This encouragement is available to all of us. And in summary, three important steps. Number one, we draw near and enter into the presence of God. That's very important. It builds your faith. And number two is for us to hold on to the promises of God. And it builds what? Hope. Hope, because of the promises of God, God who does not lie. You need to build love and hope. And number three is to have the practical ministry from you and from others so that your faith will become strong. And your love na gina-require sa atong mga Christians will become strong. You build love in this step. Sining a step, you build love inside. Love for God and then love for each other. Love for the things that God wants us to love. So, when we do these three steps, when we take the three steps, we are building an access, a resource, whereby a Christian facing the things that are happening in the last days, in these last days, will have encouragement. You're encouraged in your faith, you're encouraged in hope, and you are encouraged in love. Remember these three steps. Let us pray. In application of these three steps in our life. Hallelujah. Father in heaven, we know and we sense in our spirit that we are in the end times. We are in the last days. We don't have to enumerate the signs. We just believe in your words. We are closer to the day, and the day is approaching. And because of this, we need to prepare and understand where to go, what encouragement we need. We need your presence, constant presence, Lord, in our life. We need you in our life, O Lord. Be with us. We claim the promise that you will never leave us nor forsake us. And also, Lord, we need to take the step of fixing our faith, fixing our eyes on the Word of God and the promises of God, never forgetting the promises of God, increasing our confidence in the ability of God to perform whatever He promised. And also, Lord, we thank you, God, that you are allowing us to be prepared for these last days by the practical step of having one another, Lord. I appreciate my brothers and sisters. And Lord, we need your help and the help of the Holy Spirit to build a community of people who love each other, being considerate, giving attention to each other, and giving practical help. Hallelujah. In this meeting, O Lord, we can get encouragement, especially as we see the day approaching. Bless your people, O Lord. Make them be ready at all times for the great day of the coming of Jesus. And we ask this in His name. And every one of us say, Amen. God bless you.
Every word you have spoken will stand strong. There's nothing you can do. You're bringing the breakthrough. While I wait, I will praise you. Gotta trust you. When my eyes couldn't see it, my heart knew. You're the one I can count on. You stay true. step of my journey, I'll trust you. And no matter what happens, you are good. Yes, God. And there's nothing you can do. You're bringing the breakthrough. While I wait, I will praise you. God, I trust you.
Then sings my soul.
How great.